Zagidat was pregnant with her third child when she and her family crossed the border from Turkey to join ISIL. She says they were lured by videos portraying a land of pure Islam, but found torture, war and oppression instead. Fearing reprisals from ISIL, she doesn't want to show her face.
There was a lot of injustice there, a lot of evil. They not only tortured others, those who were not from ISIL, they were torturing the widows who lived there. That's why the place fell apart. It cannot be called Islamic State. Things that took place there do not exist in Islam.
After Zagidat's husband was killed, she managed to contact Chechen authorities and was put on a flight home, where she became part of a de-radicalization program and is carefully watched. She was one of the last women allowed to return. The Russian government now only repatriates children, much to the despair of hundreds of parents who come from all over Russia to Chechnya, urging the authorities to bring back their daughters.
It gets harder to stay hopeful. For the third year, there's no news about them.
The last phone call Fatima received from her daughter was in February 2017. Then Rezeda was in Mosul with her five children.
We hope the government will give a chance for these girls to be reunited with their mothers. If they are found, if they are alive, they should be able to live in a normal human atmosphere with the help of the state without any worries.
The organization who lobbied for their return has files of more than 700 Russian women and 1,500 children still missing.
Of course we are worried. They were women who really wanted to get to the caliphate. But those women are among the first to run away now. They can get here illegally. That is why if we bring them back through the program and under the close eye of the special services, they will be less dangerous.
While men who have returned were sent to prison, women have been given money and a place to live. Chechnya's policy of rehabilitation for former ISIL women has taken many by surprise. Ramzan Kadyrov is perhaps better known for being a tough, uncompromising leader.
An unexpected approach in a region known for its violent crackdown against people considered extremists. So this policy of returning women and children from former ISIL territories is seen by some as a way for Kadyrov to boost his poor human rights record, as well as to track potential insurgents and to promote his stature as a Muslim leader.
Heda Saratova is now trying hard to convince the authorities to bring home more women, despite criticism that she's helping people who joined a banned organization. She sees rehabilitation of these women as the safest option, making her the only hope for parents to be reunited with their children. Not only in Russia, but parents from as far away as Germany have come to her for help. Stepfasen, Al Jazeera, Grozny, Russia.